Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus University of Connecticut at Avery Point.
All right, welcome everybody to the Bishop Conley High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts for this NJCAA Region 21 matchup between the University of Connecticut at Avery Point Pointers and the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. Hi, I'm David Cadoza here on the call, alongside here with Lucy Cabral. Both teams come in today here on November 15th. They come in today with BCC comes in today at 2-2, 2-2 in Region 21. UCAP actually 2-0, 2-0 in Region 21. BCC coached by Rob DeLu in his eighth season, the architect of the BCC men's basketball program, coming off a great season last year where they finished at number 2 in Region 21 and were finalists in both the MCCAC state championships and also in the Region 21 tournament. Before tonight's game, the 1978-1979 BCC team is going to be honored and recognized here at midcourt. Again, I'm David Cadoza on the call here at Bishop Conley High School in Fall River, Massachusetts for another home game. BCC also coming up a stunning home loss last week in their home opener. Looking to avenge that loss with a win here today in front of a pretty good crowd here. The honorees of the 78-79 team. So we're going to get ready for the starting lineups. We set the scene here at Bristol Community College.
Number 35, Ray Costa. Whose broad stripes and bright stars
All right, ladies and gentlemen, what a tremendous rendition of the Star Spangled Banner by our own, FR Media's own, and our camera woman, our lovely camera woman, Miss Lucy Cabral. You can listen to the I Love Lucy show on bccradio.org on Fridays at 10 a.m. That's bccradio.org. That's Bristol Community College Bayhawk Radio. Again, that's Fridays at 10 a.m., the I Love Lucy show. And here we go, the tip-off, emotions running high. Great night for basketball. If you've seen the pregame festivities, the 78-79 men's basketball team was honored before tonight's game. And they're all in attendance. Kevin Desire jumping for the Bayhawks, and the Bayhawks will come away with it. Dan Mendes. UCAP coming in trapping. There's Armani Baker, can't get it to go. Armani Baker. Baker looking different out there with a shaved head out there. And BCC right up the tap with 2 points. Looks like it's going to be a turnover. It's going to be Bayhawks basketball. Kevin Desire to inbound. BCC been notorious slow starters during season. Oh, there's Dan Mendes. Picks up a loose ball off the side of the backboard. Running with it is UCAP. Down the other end, the jam. Misses the jam. Number two. Oh, sorry. Number three, Will Orr, misses the jam. It's going to be UCAP basketball. Going to be a foul. Looks like the foul is going to be at Daniel Mendes. And it is going to be on Daniel Mendes on the ball, on the drive, on the floor. In the corner, Will Orr for three. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by McCarthy. Swings it to Mendes. Nice play. Heads up. Going the other way. Knocked away. And they will call the foul on the act of shooting, driving to the hole. Dan Mendes will step up to the free throw line. Daniel Mendes averaging 17.5 points per game here in the early season. Again, BCC comes in at 2-2. 2-2 in Region 21. They won their last game this past weekend against Gateway, 75-58 at Gateway. BCC only playing one home game, 75-73 thriller last week in their home opener. They lost a stunner to Mass Bay last week. And they look to avenge that home loss. Trying to get back on the right track with a win. Get their first win at home this year. Here's Marcus McCarthy. McCarthy looking to drive. In the corner to Mendes. Gets it down low. Desire with the hook. Gets it to go. Kevin Desire. BCC up 6-0 early on. Will Orr in the corner being harassed by Mendes. And he loses it out of bounds. Will Orr not having a good time of it here in the early on. Missing the dunk. Losing the ball out of the... Losing the ball out of bounds, turning the ball over. Number five will come in. Mac Osius will come in for number four, Isaiah Jones. Early substitution. Marcus McCarthy with the basketball right now for BCC. Good crowd on hand. McCarthy, stutter step, gets it to the lane, no good. Armani Baker tips it. Pope will come up, can't get it to go. And BCC coming out with that energy. Spoke to Coach Rob Del Lue briefly before the game, and he was talking about his team being slow starters, and he said one of the reasons is during their warm-ups, it's kind of bland. Team's not hyped as they should be, but I think that pregame ceremony and that national anthem got them riled up. Always going to give Lucy your props, right, camera woman? You're watching this on FR Media. Armani Bacon with the first miss. If you're just joining us, 6-0. The home team, Bayhawks. Bristol Community College Bayhawks reside here in Fall River. As they play their home games here at Bishop Connolly High School. That ball is almost a disaster for UCAP. Driving the lane. And he's going to get the foul. Kevin Desire slid over. Looks like he was going to have the position. Actually, I'm sorry. I think they're going to call the foul on Dan Mendez. That's his second. Don't like to see that. And Mendez is going to come out of the game. That's one of Rob DeLue's early season studs. Mendez will come out, and number 10 will check in as Chad Nguia, forward from New Bedford, Massachusetts. And those two free throws are the first points. A lot of substitutions early on, a lot of quick substitutions. That's number 13, Kaishim McCree, who just hit both shots. He'll go out of the game. Remy Bosner, freshman guard, will come in. He's guarding Marcus McCarthy right now. Late start to the evening. The games, this men's game is following the women's game. Pope in the corner. Careless turnover right there. He had an open Anguilla and Gia in the corner there. And he carelessly just flicked it out of bounds. Here's Bosner, number 11, with the basketball. And it's a turnover. Turnover by UCAP. Going back the Bayhawks way. We're just getting our feet wet here from Bishop Connolly High School. 6-2. Where's McCarthy? Through his legs to Pope. Pope trying to bounce it into Desire. Against that ball gets knocked away. Here comes Orr, pushing it up court. Rebound Bayhawks. Knocked away by number 15, Tyrell Martinez. And it's going to go Bayhawks' way. Both teams have two team fouls. UCAP always looking to trap. Here's McCarthy to an open Pope. Swings it in. Can't get it to go. Loose ball. Looked like it was knocked away by Armani Baker, but they're going to say it's off number 21. Now they'll say, I'm sorry, number 24, Armani White, but now they'll say it is UCAP basketball. BCC matching up, man. Here's Rudy Bosner. And they're going to call a foul on Channing Guia on the arm. Number 10 with a little bit of a push. Number 13, Taishi McCree coming in for Bosner. Tough to keep up with these substitutions. BCC match it up, man. BCC likes to match up, man. And they like to put on that full court press when they get going. To the hole. To the hole is William Orr. Will Orr, number 3, gets it to go. Driving is NG in the lane. And he's going to get fouled. And I think he'll step up to the stripe. He will. Chad Ngia went to school here locally, went to New Bedford High School. He's a freshman. Returning players for Rob DeLue's Bristol Community College Bayhawks. Kevin Desire, sophomore forward from Providence, Rhode Island. Great energy player, athletic guy, good defensive player. Got block shots. Was an integral part, was in the rotation last year for Bayhawks. He brings his experience back. He went to Mount Pleasant High School. And also Armani Baker, who was a starter last year, sophomore forward plays bigger than what he is with the Pawtucket, which is Shea High School. On the other end, Bayhawks can't get it to fall. McCarthy couldn't get it to fall, or can't get the easy lay-in. Looked like he didn't know if he wanted to dunk it or lay it in. Either way, this is another easy layup. Nagir on the other side can't get it to go. Bounce pass underneath. Can't get it to go. And that's number 35. Nick Versch is into the game. I swear, these are some crazy quick substitutions. UCAP coach always keeping his team fresh, interjecting new players into the lineup when he gets a chance. Here's another substitution. Orr looks like he's coming out. For number 14, Bobby Atkins checking into the game. So all these players for the Pointers getting in on the action. Versch misses both free throws. Loose ball. Bayhawks get the ball. BCC on the zone. Quincy Pope, no good. I'm sorry, Chad Nguia, no good. Rebounded by UCAP. Man-to-man, BCC doing a good job switching. On the drive, going baseline, puts it above the glass, but they're going to call an offensive foul. They're going to call an offensive foul on number 13, Taishi McCree, sophomore guard. And Chad Ngea, he's the one that caused that foul there. Great position, taking the charge. Great hustle play. Chad McCarthy been running a lot of the point, especially with Dan Mendes not in there. Ooh, dangerous play. Baker, that's where he does his damage. Oh, not Baker, I'm sorry. That's number four. Deflected up. Inside, number 15. Tyrell Martinez with the putback. 10-6. McCarthy. Inside. Number four. Who is that? Goodness gracious. None of it on my roster. That's the mystery player. That's today's mystery player, number four. 12-6. Chad Nguia, who was out, looks to check back in. And our mystery. I'm sorry, that's not the mystery play. That was number 14. Didn't see the 1-4. Armani Baker looks different with his haircut. Sorry, no, that was number 4. I'm sorry. Goodness gracious. Here's Marcus McCarthy. McCarthy kicking it back out to number 5. Putting it up. That's Holloway. No good. Devontae Holloway on the drive. Can't get it to fall. But it's going to stay BCC basketball. Five team fouls. I'm sorry, 16 fouls counted for the guests. UCAP Pointers. Inbound to the basketball is Holloway. Gets it underneath, and they're going to call a foul. I think it's going to be on the floor, and it's going to be on Mac Osias. Osias. Sure about that call. Didn't look like it's the 7th team foul. So the 7th team foul will send number 11, Jose Mercado from Taunton, Massachusetts, the front end of a one-on-one, and he drains it. Jose Mercado, a freshman, went to Taunton High School from Taunton, Massachusetts. He's a freshman. A lot of players playing for BCC today as well. It's going all the way. What the distance? No good. Holloway with the rebound. They're going to call it over the back on him, as he caused a lot of contact when he went for that rebound, going over people, but they're going to call a foul on Holloway. That's his second. Home team Bayhawks lead 13-6. Bayhawks playing some tenacious defense on the drive, losing it out of bounds. And another turnover for UCAP. BCC at their best when they're causing havoc on the defensive end and being able to get into their play fast break basketball. And they're causing a lot of turnovers here early on. And they really haven't put the pressure on, in my estimation. Ooh, nice faking and drive by McCarthy. Try to get it down low to the mystery man, number four. Holloway for, they're going to count up as two. Nice follow-away by Holloway. 15-6. UCAP early on getting themselves here in a lot of foul trouble. They got 17 fouls already here in the first half with 13:45 to play. So a long way to go. Before you know it, BCC is going to be in the double bonus. Only three fouls away. I don't think BCC has looked like a well-oiled machine by any means. Dan Mendez has gone out of the game for the time being. Now, one of the top scorers for BCC with two fouls in the early on. And BCC, as well as UCAP, playing a lot of their role players, a lot of their bench players are getting in on the action here early on. Quick timeout by UCAP. UCAP has the basketball, BCC match it up man. Again, Coach Rob Del Lue in his eighth season. BCC was finalist last year in the MCCAC state championships. And then also were a finalist in the Region 21 championships. They went to the finals. Loose ball on the court. Chad and Gia with the basketball. UCAP always hustling to the basketball. Give them that. Nice pass by Holloway to the mystery guy, number four, who lays it up and in. 17-6 now. Nice bounce pass by Devontae Holloway, freshman from Salem, Massachusetts, land of the witches. Loose ball, almost knocked away. Oh, nice dribble move. Puts it up and no good. And it's offensive foul. Offensive foul. And that mystery man is the guy that induced that. Mac Osea. So had a nice dribble drive to the basket, but then number four was there to stop him. Here comes BCC, loose ball. And McCarthy will bring it out for the Bayhawks, 17-6. McCarthy being guarded closely. Ball away jumper, no good. Tipped up and it's gonna be off Blue. It's gonna be off UCAP. Number 35 will check in. Nick Fersh will come in for number 24, Amadi White. Ooh, nice play. Holloway for three, no good. Rebounded by number 11, Jose Masato. New shot clock. Holloway, bottom of three. Now he tries to the hole. Strong move, lays it in. 19-6. in on the other end, number 35, McFirsch, freshman guard. McCarthy, chatting wheel on the baseline. Baseline jumper, no good. Rebounded by the scrappy number 4, no good. Rebounded by Bosner. Bosner quick with the basketball. Three, Will Orr for three. No good, coming off and rebounded by McCarthy. Marcus McCarthy driving length of the four. Bounce pass in the corner. Jose Brasado, three-pointers, no good. BCC had the basketball and a new shot clock. Take it away. Oh, what a block. Oh, my goodness. But they're going to call a foul there. Nice strong take by number 13, Taishi McCree, the sophomore guard, taking it right at number 4, who presumably had a good block there. Looked like he had all ball, but must have got him with the body. Rob Del Lue doesn't like it. So Taishi McCree will step up to the line for the pointers, 19-8. Drains that free throw. Whole new cast of characters coming in for the Bayhawks. Number 14, Armani Baker's back in. Dan Mendes will check back in for the Bayhawks. And also number 13, Quincy Pope will check back in. Big guns coming back in for BCC. Free throw coming off. Rebounded by Baker. Mendes coming back in with his quickness. With Mendes and McCarthy and Pope, those guys are a tremendous quickness. They're going to look to push and drive the basketball. Baker at the free throw line, taking it in. No good. Rebounded by Will Orr. And then telegraph because Holloway going to the hole. Won't make it, but he'll go to the free throw line. He's fouled. Looks like he'll be fouled by number 4. By number 3, Will Orr will cause a foul. Number 2 fouls. Now by Mr. Will Orr. 19 fouls for UCAP. First free throw was missed by Devontae Holloway. Another one of Rob Del Lue's freshmen. Getting a lot of burn. With him and Chad Anguilla, Jose Mercado. A lot of these guys coming off the bench, contributing for the Bayhawks here early. 19-9, both free throws missed by Holloway. So dump it down inside. Turn around, can't get it to go. That was Tyrell Martinez down low, couldn't get it to go. Here's Mendes, too quick for his own good. They'll call a shot clock violation, but there's no way that's a shot clock violation. The buzzer goes off. But they'll reset that clock, or they'll put it back at 21 seconds. Not sure why it went down to zero. Went from zero to 21, or 21 to zero, I should say. Mendes driving to his left. In the corner is Ngea. Baker, that's his shot right there. Baker, boy, when he gets the ball in the corner, when he goes baseline, that's where he dominates. That's where he likes to get the basketball, and he gets two. 21-9. Teams now in the bonus in 13. Taishi McCree misses the front end of a 1-on-1. Going the length of the court as Mendez gains some contact, but they won't call a foul. They lose it out of bounds. And the Bayhawks turn the ball over. UCAP basketball. Gotta go the length of the court. BCC matching up man-man. Full length of the court. Armani Baker all over the basketball. And it looks like they're going to call a foul. They're going to call on the foul number 14, Armani Baker. That's going to be two on him. A lot of time left here in the first half, and both teams will be shooting free throws after every foul now. Both teams are in the bonus, approaching the double bonus. 18 fouls for the Bayhawks, 9 for the guest University of Connecticut at Avery Point. God, that's a long name. Pointers. Let's keep it at UCAP. Free throw missed by McCray. Pushing it the other way is Mendez. Mendez getting his team in the offense. Getting into the lane, and goodness gracious. What a hack job there by number 22, Ryan Tobin. And Mendez will step up to the line. And that's going to put BCC in the double bonus. They'll be shooting two free throws the rest of the way in the first half. 10 team fouls on UCAP. And every foul that they commit from here on out and in the first half for the next 9 minutes and 31 seconds, going to be two free throws. Little margin for error there. BCC has a lot of quick guys that are hard to stay in front of. Can be hard to defend. A lot of athletic, quick guys. A lot of agility, a lot of quickness. Going to be tough not to follow those boys. 22-9. Going the other way. BCC getting back on defense. Match it up man-to-man. That's what they do. Holding UCAP to single digits thus far. Rosado getting in the passing lane. Going the distance, but he won't be able to connect, but he will go to the free throw line. Again, if you're just joining us, it was a pregame ceremony for the 1978-1979 Bristol Community College men's basketball team. They were the MCCAC champions that year. Had a great year. They went 18-3 going into that tournament. Great season for that team. They were being honored. If you know guys like Dave Houtman and Art Goyette, they were two big cogs for that team. They were coached by head coach Bob Dempsey. And assistant coach by Mike Vieira. A lot of good players on that team. They were honored before tonight's game. They were congratulated. President Sprague was here, along with athletic director Derek Riveros and others, to honor that team. So, another turnover for you, Cap. Only the second home game for BCC. They've been on the road most of the time. Mendez in the corner from Rosado. Gets it to go. The southpaw from the corner with a nice dribble drive by Mendez. Finds an open Rosado for three, 26-9. UConn always changing their play. I mean, UCAP, sorry, not UConn. Driving to the hole. And it looks like a push-off. Look if they're going to call. Not sure what the call is on the court. I thought it might have been a push-off by Amadi White. Driving to the hole. Either way, it's a turnover. BCC basketball. And that pass taken, stolen by number 15, Tyrell Martinez. Stealing the ball at half court. And drive it to the hole. Nice hustle play by that guy. UCAP finally in double figures. BCC looking to go 3-2. As well as be 3-2 in the region. Mendes being guarded by Bobby Atkins. McCarthy, that's a deep three. And he sinks it with the confidence and with smoothness. Marcus McCarthy for deep, 29-11. Definitely gonna have confidence in that shot to stroke it, and he did just that. Here's Atkins. Atkins. And now falling on the floor. Kevin Desire going the way. Lays it up and in. Desire showing great athleticism. Now going back the other way and laying it up and in is Tyrell Martinez. And he's athletic. Mendes pushing up the other way, loses it. Coming away with it is Atkins. Got numbers. Taking it to the hole, lays it up, and drops it in. Nice play by Bobby Atkins. Didn't see that coming. 31-15. Both teams going back and forth. And Martinez will commit the foul, and Desire will go to the free throw line. Kevin Desire from Providence, Rhode Island. Went to Mount Pleasant High School. He's a sophomore. Was part of last year's BCC team, who finished number 2 overall in Region 21 in the NJCAA. First free throw was good. Kevin Desire's offensive game definitely looks like it's took leaps and bounds from last year. As you've seen him, when he gets it out in the open court, definitely had himself under control. Nice ball handling for a big guy and laid it up and in. That was both free throws missed, though, by Desire. 32-15. Kevin Desire averaging 7.5 points a game here in the early season. Now in the starting lineup, Will Orr. Will Orr now being collapsed on by McCarthy and Anguilla. And I think they're going to commit a foul here. They are. Not sure who the foul is going to be on. They're going to call a foul on Chad Anguilla. He's got 2. Kevin Desire out of the game now. In the game for BCC is number 11, Jose Versado. You get the mystery player, number 4. Number 14, Armani Baker. And number 10, and Chad Anguilla. That's who's in the ball game right now for the Bayhawks. Bayhawks in their home white attire with the green trimmings. And UCAP in blue with the red lettering, the red trim. We're here at Bishop Connolly High School in Fall River, Massachusetts, right next to the campus of Bristol, a beautiful Bristol Community College, because Bristol. Rosado dumps it in on the baseline. Baker trying to do his dirty work, and he'll go to the free throw line. Armani Baker likes to get the ball right there on the baseline. And there's a lot of players that aren't willing to take that baseline away. And Armani Baker is strong enough and athletic enough where he just gets the ball right below, right before the block. And he's got the athleticism to take a couple steps to just get to where he wants to go to. And it seems like it's hard to stop. Got to take that baseline away. One thing that I learned, playing basketball, one thing that I learned that the coaches hate when you let a player blow by you on the baseline. You got to be willing to put that foot out there and get position and be able to beat that player to the spot and gain the charge, or at least prevent them from getting an easy hoop. But Armani Baker's been able to dominate when he gets the ball. That's his patented shot. Atkins from the elbow, jumper up. Gonna be a foul. It looks like the foul is gonna be on Marcus McCarthy. Looks to be his first foul of the evening. 6-11 here to play, 33-16. First free throw is made for UCAP's Amadi White, freshman forward. Both free throws made, 33-18. McCarthy looking to push the other way. In the corner, Jose Brasado likes that shot, no good. Rebounded by Holloway, got guys all over him. Back out to Brasado, new shot clock. Sorry, McCarthy. Ball number four, lays it up and in. 35-18. Driving to the hole, putting it up. And they're gonna call a charge. BCC beating UCAP players to the spot. That's at least a third or fourth charge that they've gained tonight. Charging call. I believe that foul is going to be on number 13, Taishi McCree. Breaking the trap is BCC. By number four on the baseline. Puts it up off the glass. No good. Tipped up. Rebound. Second effort. No good. But going to the line is the mystery man. For the mystery man, because he's not on my roster. First free throw was missed, second free throw was missed as well. Coming away with it, UCAP. Driving late to the court to Bobby Atkins. No good. Rebounded by Isaiah Jones. He'll bring it back out and start a new shot clock. Number 24 limping out the court. Number 15 coming in, Tyrell Martinez. That's number 24, Amadi White. Both teams in the double bonus here in the first half. Both teams hacking it up. Isaiah Jones to inbound. Driving, spinning into the lane, and it's going to be steps. Tyrone Martinez turns the ball over, travels. Here goes Marcus McCarthy. Driving. Hop step, no good. Going the other way. Knocked away, good defensive play by Devontae Holloway, knocking it away from Taishi McCree. Lucy almost dumped the camera on the scorer's table down below. Will Orr dribbles in, no good. Loose ball. BCC, oh, nice play, oh, but then Will Orr. And it looked like Will Orr stepped out. And it's gonna be BCC basketball. Inbound to number four. Ball knocked away by Will Orr. Again, UCAP comes in here 2-0, 2-0 in region 21. Monte Holloway, inbounds, number four, short jumper, it's good. He's been pretty damn good. 37-18. Driving the lane is McCree. Gets it down inside. Falling down. And he's going to go to the free throw line. Tyrell Martinez. Tyrell Martinez showing great athleticism today for a big guy, or a guy who's presumably supposed to be the interior presence for UCAP, is showing great agility, great athleticism, getting into the passing lanes, zooming in, picking balls off at half court and taking it to the distance, showing great leaping ability. He's a freshman forward. Fourth 38 to play here in the first half. Second free throw is buried home. 37-19. Marcus McCarthy guarded closely by Isaiah Jones. In the corner, Chad Ngea for three. No good. BCC not shooting good from outside at all. Here's Martinez, loses the ball out of bounds. Both teams turn the ball over. I don't think this has been a crisply played game from the offensive end by any stretch of the imagination. BCC's been pretty good on defense. Field goal percentage isn't that good, especially shooting from the outside. Trap by UCAP. That's Jose Brasada for three. Another three coming off, no good. That's McCree, he'll lose it. He's fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line. Again, both teams will be going to the free throw line after every foul for the rest of the first half. Been like that for the last 10 minutes. Again, it's only yours truly here on the call. Doing the play-by-play all day, Mr. Dave Cardozo along with Lucy Cabral. Yeah. First free throw made by Tysheen McCree. Coming into the game now is Armani Baker. Coming in for Chad Ngea. Both free throws made by McCree. Ngea back to McCarthy. To Holloway. Nice cutting. Cut it to the hole is desire, but he couldn't get it to go. And now we have a loose ball foul on UCAP, and Armani Baker will step up to the free throw line. And I'm sorry, that wasn't Chad Ngea that went out. That was number 13, Quincy Pope. Chad Ngea is still in the game, number 10. Baker will shoot two. Drains the first one. Amadi White will come in. Will come into the game for the UCAP pointers. Baker hits both free throws. 39-21, 18-point lead. Driving to his right, kicking out to Orr for three. Can't get it to fall. Orr gets his own rebound. Heads up play. Can't get it to fall. Osias couldn't connect down low on the offensive rebound. McCree. Now back out to Jones. 17 on the shot clock. This is what BCC does. They force you. Oh, laying in. Nice pass. Nice pass by Jones. Finding Osias. They force you to shoot at the end of the shot clock. Part of what they do. Baker in the corner. Back out to McCarthy. Rob Delalue will call a timeout. We'll keep it here. 39-23, 16-point lead for the Bayhawks. All right, part of the 10 things you need to know tonight. Head coach Rob Del Lew is the first Bristol head coach to reach 100 wins. He did that last year on December 10th of 2015. Only more wins to come for that man. The Bayhawks returned three players from their 2015-2016 roster. One of them is Kevin Desire, Armani Baker, and Ryan Stopka from Rochester, Massachusetts, went to Old Colony High School. And like I said, last year the Bayhawks finished runner-up at the 2016 Region 21 tournament. They lost to Bunker Hill in the Region 21 tournament, and they also lost to Bunker Hill in the MCCAC state championship there. So Bunker Hill is one of the hurdles they're going to have to get over with. They're going to have to get over if they want to make it to Minnesota, where the national championships will be held. The NJCAA national tournament will be held in Minnesota this year, the land of the lakes. It's moving from upstate New York and moving to Minnesota. So Coach Rob Del Lew, his teams have never made it to the national tournament. If they can do it this year, it'll be the first time. So Coach Rob Del Lew and company looking to make it to the Great Northwest over there. Oh, that ball picked off by Jones. He's going to go the length of the court, plays it up and in. Picked his pocket. Nice steal by Jones. Heads up play there. The lead is cut to 14. McCarthy finds Baker. Drives towards the paint. Loses it. Pits it back up and in. Heads up play by Armani Baker. Stays with it. Lays it in. Going back the other way. Jones in a crowd. Gives it to Orr. Doesn't have the ups to put it in. Gets his own rebound and puts it back up and in. Second effort. Be a frustrating thing for a team and for a coach when you give up those second and third chance points. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Holloway, seven on the shot clock. Baker finds McCarthy for three, no good, coming off. Definitely off the rim, so it's going to stay BCC basketball. Holloway will inbound for the Bayhawks. Finding number 10. And Gia, no good. Holloway coming back in, can't get it to go. Loose ball, and it's going to be a foul on Holloway. BCC right now, you got to finish the first half with energy and you get a, and assertiveness and just finish out the half. But this is how you allow teams to creep back in. You know, a 16 point lead can be can go up in flames quick. We've seen it time from time with from this BCC team or any team really. It can happen. Because right now, what was a 17-point lead, 18-point lead, is 41-29. It's a 12-point lead. Can't get kills with the basketball. Gonna have solid possessions. Baker can't make it. Desire finds an open Anguilla, gets it blocked. Baker comes up with it, and Gia can't make it. Tipped up by Baker, nothing doing. Going back the other way. Orr on Desire, puts it up, off the glass and in. What a move. Was able to turn his body just enough to flick it up with the right hand, and it's a 10-point lead. Going around the back end, Gia. McCarthy, nice take. No good. Baker puts it up. Can't get it up. Baker gets a lot of second and third chance opportunities. Sometimes he seems a little undersized. Definitely plays bigger than his height underneath there, but he's the guy that does all the dirty work on the boards. Definitely a big piece of the puzzle. Armani Baker. Armani Baker is shooting nearly 63% from the field and is averaging nearly 15 points a game, averaging 14.8 points per game as he makes both free throws there. So those two free throws big right there to keep UCAP at bay for a second. Well, we get a game here at BCC. Nice drive, nice round the back to Orr for three. Up, oh, goodness gracious, what a tremendous play by Jones on the drive. Jones going around the back again, loses control of the basketball, and then he's going to be called for steps. He's going to be called for a travel. But what a play by Jones there, driving to the hole. And had a nice around the, what an around the, nice around the back pass to Orr, who almost drained it. Almost had to drain it, but he couldn't do it. Baker, they'll lose it. Now it goes back up. Oh, goodness gracious. Orr, the open floor, looking to jam it, and he gets fouled. Fouled by Baker, goes to the line. Cuts the lead to within eight. And these are exactly the things that you don't need to happen. Are things that just can't happen at the end of a half. Thought they cut it to within eight here. That free throw was made. Down nine. Versado pulls up for three. Up, bounces up, no good. And that's going to be the end of the first half. So the UCAP pointers end the first half on a little bit of a roll as both teams will run to the half. 43-34, the pointers down nine to the home team Bayhawks. For David Cadeau's, Lucy Cabral here on the call. All right, so we're gonna take these next few to take a break here. It is halftime for Bishop Connolly High School, 43-34 Bayhawks. We'll be right back with second half action. All right, welcome everybody back to Bishop Connolly High School as we get ready to start the second half of action here in Fall River, Massachusetts, right next to the beautiful campus of Bristol Community College. I'm David Cardoza here on the call alongside me is our camera woman, our lovely camera lady, and the singer of today's national anthem, Miss Lucy Cabral, as we broadcast here on FR Media. And we're getting underway here. UCAP in blue, you're just joining us, Will Orr. Gonna be Bayhawks basketball, and our mystery player, number four, is Desmond Jernigan. He's number four. Desmond Jernigan in a previous number, number 20, playing the old switcheroo. Here's Desmond, here's Daniel Mendez with the basketball. Seven on the shot clock. UCAP playing good defense out the gate. Ball away jumper by Mendez, can't get it to go. Rebounded by Desire, finds an open Pope and lays it in. Great job by Kevin Desire to get the rebound and find a cutting Pope going to the hole. 45-34. I think BCC got kind of relaxed the last couple of minutes of the first half as they let a 17-point lead dwindle down to nine. Now back up to 11. UCAP. To inbound the basketball here. McCree finds Orr for three in the corner. Will Orr for three. And it's an 8-point ball game. BCC has controlled this game from all game. McCarthy on the drive, off the glass, no good. Baker all over the boards, and McCarthy, they'll come away with it. Not sure what the call is, but it's going to stay right here. Going to stay right here for the Bayhawks. Pope, back up to McCarthy at the top, they'll swing it. Mendes from the wing for three. Lovely, lovely. Mendes with his first three of the night. Bayhawks back on D, playing man-to-man. Dribble drive. Losing it is McCree, coming away with it is Mendes. Pope, Mendes, and McCarthy in the backcourt for the Bayhawks. Trying to get it into Desire, knocked away. Will Orr taking it, length of the court, puts it up and in. Great way to use his body was Will Orr, the drive on the lay-in. Well, we've seen that a couple times with Will Orr. He really knows how to use his body, not the most athletic of players, but when it comes to driving to the basket, he knows how to use his body and very imaginative with the basketball. Here's McCarthy. Drives to his left, kicked it back out to Pope for three. Can't knock it down. Rebound by Orr. Orr starting to step his game up now. Came out of the gates kind of slow, kind of struggled early, but he's really been able to turn it on. BCC bench into the game with chance of defense. Jones back out for three. Almighty White with the miss, coming away with his Mendes. Like buzzing like a bumblebee, kicks it out, kicks it in to Baker, cutting. He can't make it, but he'll step up to the free throw stripe. Charity stripe. Baker goes to the line for two, 48-39. Late night here, we get off to a late start. The UCAP, the University of Connecticut at Avery Point, women's and men's basketball team got here to Fall River a little bit later than expected with inclement weather outside. Windy, rainy, wet, traffic, all that. So we didn't get started till about 6:30 with the women's basketball. Earlier, the women's BCC women's basketball team lost 109-66. Another blowout loss at home for Coach Aaron Morell and company. And that game was followed, obviously, by this game with the BCC men's basketball team going against UCAP here in the nightcap. The 1978-1979 BCC men's basketball team was honored earlier today. That ceremony took a little bit. As we are approaching 10 o'clock here in the evening, we got a late one. By the time you watch this on FBAR Media in its recorded state, it won't be that late. But for us, it's late. Armani Baker at the line. Looking to put his team up 11. Second free throw is good. Baker has 9 points on today. Our mystery player, number four, Desmond Jernigan, he has 10. Orr driving the baseline, put it up with the left, couldn't get it to go. Rebounded by Pope. Finds McCarthy on the wing, but it's knocked away by Jones. Jones kicks it back out. Cross court pass, how did it get there? Orr for three, off the rim. Rebounded by McCarthy. McCarthy, full length of the court pass to Mendes, pops for three and gets it. His second free throw of the half. Danny Mendes, number one, his second three, puts BCC back up by double figures, up by 14 now. That's going to be a foul on number 13. Quincy Pope, the freshman from Acushnet, Mass. 13 white push out of bounds sideline. That's who it appears to be on with the body. He's got three fouls now. Coming up on 16 minutes to play. BCC still matching up man to man. Jones gets it down inside. Oh, goodness gracious. Nice pass. Nice pass by Armani White. Who get it to Mac Osias on the backdoor cut. Pretty play there. Great pass by Armani White. And now it looks like it's going back. No, it's going to be a foul. And Daniel Mendez will step up to the line. Again, Daniel Mendez averaging 17 and a half points a game. Only had three in the first half, but he's got 2 3-pointers out the gate here in the second half. The leading scorer for the BCC men's basketball team. You talk about guys like Mendez and Quincy Pope and Marcus McCarthy. Those three guards they got a lot of speed. They really know how to push the basketball. They can get their own shot off. Baker with the rebound off the missed free throw. Couldn't get it to go. Going back the other way. Oh, finding it. Tyrell Martinez gets it up and in. Mendez tries to get in the paint, kicks it back out. McCarthy swings it in the corner. Back to Mendez for three. Can't get it to go this time. Almost. In and out. McCree back in the corner for three. It's good. How about that? Remy Bosner for three. That's going to keep the road team in it. 54-46. UCAP hanging around. BCC has done that time over the years, or at least my years of calling BCC basketball the last few seasons. They let teams hang around for too long. They had a big lead in the first half. They let UCAP get on kind of a run, feel good about themselves at the end of the first half there. Baker using his body. And there's going to be a foul. It's going to be on UCAP. Looks like it's going to be on number 15. Tyrell Martinez. And that looks like it's going to be his fourth. And that's danger for him right now. And danger for UCAP, losing one of their better players to foul trouble. If he doesn't go out, no substitutions. Doesn't look like any substitutions imminent for UCAP. He'll stay in the game. Number 11, Jose Ricardo will come in for number 13, Quincy Pope. The Pope will step out. Baker at the line. Can't get it to fall. Nice rebound by Jernigan. Formerly known as the mystery man, now we know that's Desmond Jernigan. Driving to the hole is McCarthy. Bounce pass to Baker where he likes it, but can't get it to go. Jernigan cleans it up, puts it up and in, gets the foul, and it will step up to the line for the old-fashioned three-point play or opportunity to get it anyways. Let you know, this gymnasium here at Bristol Community College, Bishop Conley High School, the home of the Bayhawks men's basketball team in their games. It is hot as heck in here. The walls are sweating. It's getting hot. The action's getting hot here. Look at Remy Bosner. Speed. He's going to take it all the way. Almost lost it there. Deflected by Rosado. Nice save, or had a chance to save it, but he couldn't. Good hustle there by Jose Mercado. State UCAP basketball. Inbounding will be number 11. UCAP's number 11, Boston. They'll get it inside. Martinez working, puts it up, and gets it to go, gets it to fall. Nice post move there by Martinez. McCarthy gets it over the timeline in the corner. Rosado lays it up with the left hand, driving to his right and lays it up with his left. And Ricardo quietly having a nice game for himself. Barsner calling out the play. BCC still there man-to-man. Try to dump it into Martinez, denied by Holloway. Holloway going coast-to-coast and lays it in. Count it. How about that? Devontae Holloway, the freshman from Salem. Nice denial of the basketball by Holloway on one end. On the careless inbound pass, Holloway took the interior pass and took it the other way and kept it all the way. Went coast to coast, laid it up and in, draw the foul, and BCC will stay up 14 with 13:52 left to play. And a timeout on the court. 16 fouls already by UCAP. They're in foul trouble. And we'll keep it here on FR Media. Coach Rob DeLu doing what he does, coaching. And he's got a lot of his players playing. I mean, his bench is deep. A lot of guys contributing today. From Bayhawks, from Dan Mendez, to Devontae Holloway, who's come off the bench. Mr. Desmond Jernigan, who didn't start, but he's come off the bench to score 10 points of his own. Chad and G has come in and played an integral role. Jose Mercado, Quincy Pope, Armani Baker, McCarthy, Desire, all these guys playing for BCC. And all scoring. Been a collective effort for sure, especially on the defensive end where BCC works his magic. Holloway can't complete the three-point play. Or in the corner, drives baseline. Baker can't get position, he'll commit the foul. That foul's only on the floor. No free throws needed. Third team foul for the home team, Bayhawks. You're watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media. Home of the Bayhawks. Going to the hole is Osias. No good. Tipped up. Rebounded by Martinez. Puts up the right hand hook and in. Good job by Terrell Martinez. 60-52, UCAP continues to hang around. BCC still needs to be on the attack. Here's Marcus McCarthy. This is where you need to have guys with killer instinct. Mendez drives the lane, kicks it out to Jernigan, jumper, no good. Rebounded by Bobby Atkins. Whole team's flying up and down the court. Martinez trying to get position. On the block, then on Holloway. Holloway went to deflect the ball, and he'll commit the foul. Another team foul, be a four on BCC. Been a fast-paced game, been a quick, fast-paced game. Both teams looking to fast break any chance they can get. BCC playing that tenacious man-to-man defense. Get the ball in. Back Osias drives the lane, drives the baseline, puts it up off the window and in. UCAP match it up, man. McCarthy on the wing to Mendez. Back out of the top. Danny Mendez for three. Rainbow, no good. Rebounded by McCree. Bobby Atkins underneath to Martinez. Good team basketball there. Way to keep it moving for UCAP. Took three passes to get down court and a score. Mendez looking to get in the lane. looking to pass it to Holloway. Going to be an offensive foul. I think it's going to be on Danny Mendez. And it is. He needs to be careful now. He has three fouls. To 54, 12:20 to play. Yeah, if you just heard me sigh, yeah, it's been one of those nights. It's hot in here. Long night. Doubleheader basketball for both the Lady Bayhawks and the Men Bayhawks. 62-54. Mac Lasayas. Right, good job to beat the trap. William Moore down inside, it will score. BCC with their half-court trap, and UCAP doing a great job of moving the basketball. Mendez gets it inside to Pope. Good hang time there, he's gonna get fouled, and I think he'll be going to the free throw line. To 56. 11:55 to play. Pope will sink that one. 7-point lead. In a blink of an eye, I mean, this was just a 14-point lead just a couple minutes ago. It's now down to 7. It was a 17-point lead in the first half, 18-point lead in the first half. And UCAP has just hung around and just stood in it. It's an 8-point lead now. BCC, this is the time they need to put them to bed. These next few minutes are integral for BCC. They're going to put these guys to bed, these next 3 or 4 minutes. Here's McCree at the top. Finds Atkins in the corner, gets it down low. The collapse on Martinez, back up to Atkins for three. Can't knock it down. Rebound, no. Rebounded by BCC. McCarthy comes away with it. Long pass. Oh, goodness gracious. Jernigan can try to save it. And Mac Osias will step out of bounds. Desmond Jernigan looks like he's hurt out there. See him hold to the arm. Bent down grimacing. He'll stay in the game. Not sure. I think Coach Del Lu asked if he's okay. He'll stay in the game though. 64-56. 11:22 left in this one. In this sweatshop. Goodness gracious. Where is the AC when you need it? 60 degrees outside, I think. I don't know. Marcus McCarthy. Tremendous. At the elbow, back up top, McCarthy. Jump shot by Pope, can't get it to fall. Tipped up, Atkins comes away with it. UCAP looking to break, and that ball's gonna get deflected, and they're gonna say it's off UCAP. Chad Ngia will come in for Danny Mendez, give him a spell. We're almost halfway through the second half in this one. Stop hitting me, Lucy. All right. Here we go. 8-point lead. BCC moving the ball around. 10 on the shot clock. Getting into the lane. All the way. Nice block. Blocked by Orr on McCarthy's drive. Going the distance. Here's McCree. Puts it up. And he can't connect, but he'll go to the line for two. Throw is made by McCree, Tysheen McCree, sophomore guard. He had 5 points at the half. Hits both free throws here. He's got got 9 now. 62-64 to 58, 10 and a half minutes to play. Down to a 6-point lead. This is the smallest BCC lead since the first opening minutes. This is the first 3 or 4 minutes of the first half. Baker taking it from the outside. Hit. Pushing it back the other way. Mac Osias, look at his speed. Gets it to Atkins, can't lay it in. The putback by Martinez is no good. Again, going up. It looks like it's going to stay here. UCAP can't capitalize on their second chance opportunities, but Tyrell Martinez will step up to the line. The foul is going to be on number 30, Kevin Desire. That's his first. Well, if you know BCC, when they play at home, not sure what it is, but they definitely have the gumption for thrillers. We might be in for another thriller now. Martinez misses the free throw. But he gets the ball back, and he'll go to the line again, it looks like. Martinez, definitely a guy who likes to mix it, who can definitely mix it up on the interior. He's built like a you-know-what house. And he'll go back into the line. Now, BCC has 18 fouls now. In a blink of an eye, it went from 2 to 8. One and one. Actually, that was on the shot, so it's going to be a two. It's a two-shot. It's a two-shot foul. The first one is miss regardless. Martinez looking to make this the smallest BCC lead since the opening 4 minutes. Can't do it. Misses both free throws. BCC getting away with one there. Oh, Orr almost committed a foul there with the body. 15 on the shot clock. McCarthy drives into the lane, ball away. Martinez looks like he got a piece of it. Here comes Bosner. And they're gonna call that out of bounds on BCC. McCarthy will come out for BCC. Danny Mendez in, Bosner inbounding. Here's Atkins. Oh, nice pass. Oh, goodness gracious. Good passing there from the pointers. Mark Macasias lays it up and in. And he kicks it off. Spins in the lane. Gets fouled by Mendez. And he'll be going to the free throw line. And the UCAP women's team likes it. The UCAP women's team was victorious. 109 points today by that team. Great job by those girls. Beat the Lady Bayhawks 109-66. They have obviously here for the game and cheering on their boys. That first free throw is good. It is now a 3-point lead. What was nearly a 20-point lead in the first half has now dwindled down to 3. Mac Osias hits both free throws. And it is a 2-point lead with lots of time left. Now we'll see what BCC's made of. If they can persevere through this storm they're going through right now. Because it looks like they have to work for everything. Desire from the elbow, can't get it to go. Rebounded by Orr. Orr driving it the other way, gonna take it a distance, off the glass, ties the game. Ties the game. Will Orr. And it's 64-64. Timeout on the court by Rob Delalu. Wow. And what was nearly a 20-point lead at one point has just gone up in flames. 64-64. Timeout on the court by Robbie D and company. Under 9 to play from Bishop Conley. So it looks like we're in for a exciting finish as we usually are in these home games here for BCC at Bristol at Bishop Conley. I don't know what it is, but it seems like BCC always plays in these thrillers and have flares for dramatics, for the dramatic at the time at times. So we'll see how this one shapes up. 10 things you need to know. Here's a couple more of them. The Bayhawks. Danny Mendez and Quincy Pope led Bayhawks scorers at Quinn Singamon with 21 points each. That was their first win of the season. Bayhawks are averaging under 76 points a game for the season. UCAP is 2-0 on the season. Also defeated Gateway earlier this year by a score of 87-79. Will Orr had 20 points in that game and 9 boards, while Taishim McCree had 18 points and 6 rebounds. And those guys are the two vital cogs for that UCAP men's basketball team. You see Will Orr, just by the eye contest, you can see that he is the engine that makes this thing go. BCC is 6-1 versus UCAP since 2012. UCAP looking to try to put an end to that run. Kevin Desire will inbound for the Bayhawks. It's Bayhawks time right now. Here's Baker. Baker looking to go in on Orr, and it's going to be steps. Looked like he lost control of it and then took too many steps. Tie basketball game. Here's Remy Bosner, the freshman guard, who's coming off the bench to run the point at times. Done a pretty good job of doing it. Here's Bobby Atkins. Atkins on the drive, kicks it back up to Will Orr, driving baseline. And it looks like there's a foul on the drive. Thought he might have stepped out of bounds there. Evidently, that's not the case. Will Orr will step up to the free throw line. 10 points at the half. Will Orr had, despite a shaky start for him. He's really piled it on here. He's got more points here in the second half. First free throw was made. And UCAP finds themselves with their first lead of the evening. BCC started off the game with a 6-0 run and never looked back as they had leads as large as 17-18. For three is good, that's huge. That three is huge by Chad and Gia to stop the bleeding. This game could have quickly went downhill, and Chad and Gia with a big clutch three in the corner. Atkins and Bosner. Now at the top, Osias. Orr back out to Bosner. Bosner was looking for three. Seven on the shot clock. Good defense by BCC. Orr for a long three. No good coming off. Huge rebound by Armani Baker to get up for that one. Long pass down to McCarthy, no good. Big rebound there by Desire to put it back and in. And BCC, just like that, is three. UCAP had the lead, but not for long. Martinez can't get that one to go. Good job by BCC. I'm impressed with their perseverance to weather the storm. UCAP took a temporary lead by two, but it was short-lived because Chad and Gia had that big corner three. And then the following possession, Kevin Desire, big energy guy, with the follow-up with the putback. BCC up three. Armani Baker will step up to the line. And BCC has a chance to make hay and hopefully add on to this lead. Talking with Coach Rob Del Lew, his team sometimes can, they kind of lose themselves a little bit. Sometimes with a big lead, or get a little bit too lax. He knows they need to put their foot to the throat, and that's what these next couple minutes are going to be. You let a team like UCAP, let them hang around. They'll get inside, we'll turn around and lay it in. Jernigan went for the steal, Orr grabbed it and put it off the glass and in. 1 point lead. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen, we got a great finish for you. McCarthy, back out for three to Mercado, no good. Rebound by Quincy Pope. Quincy Pope mixes it up inside, and he will go to the free throw line. That's 19 fouls on UCAP. UCAP already in the double bonus, 10 team fouls for the Bayhawks. That free throw is good. First free throw is good.
Arkansas shoot. Back to 32.
And both free throws are good. 71-68. I'm sorry, one free throw is good. We got a loose ball that will stay right here. Here comes Mac Osias. Sitting down is number 22, Ryan Tobin. They'll go into the corner. They try to get it to Orr for three. He was open there, but was knocked away by Armani Baker. Good defensive play there. 6:24 to go. McCree will take it. Tysheen McCree will take it from the corner to Osias. Drive it to his right. Lays it up. Can't get it to go. Nice rebound by Angia. Also McCarthy on the wing. Pope. There's Chad Angia for three, rolls out. Putting up the rebound is Jernigan, it's good. Good job on the offensive boards by Desmond Jernigan. One of the leading scorers today for BCC. Orr on the drive, on the baseline, no good. Loose ball, and the Bayhawks come away with it. 5 point lead, getting into winning time. Going into the lane, puts it up, no good. Offensive rebounds, BCC out hustling and gets every loose ball on the offensive boards. Armani Baker cleans that one up, and BCC, just like that, is back up seven. 75-68, 5:39 left to play. All right, so we're gonna keep it here, 75-68. BCC control this whole basketball game. Up until the last few minutes, UCAP has stood around and has really worked to stay into this basketball game. BCC, you know, with some careless plays, some turnovers, you know, getting a little lax at times, kind of fell behind, but they've woken up here. BCC has led the whole game, and then UCAP, University of Connecticut, at Avery Point, the Pointers, took their first lead at 66-64, but right after that, that lead was quickly erased, and that was a big shot by Angia. That was the play of the game right there. Because, you know, you let UCAP build on that lead, it can kind of snowball real quick, so that was a big, big shot there. Shot of the game. BCC with a trap. Terrell Martinez. Kicks it back out. They'll get inside to Mac Osias. Nice pass there by Fersh to Cutting Osias, who puts it up quickly and in. 5 point lead, coming up on five to go. On the drive, Quincy Pope. Lost control of it, and they're gonna call an offensive foul. Didn't have control of it when he went up. And getting the position is Tyrell Martinez. I tell you, he's all over the place. Great hustle player. And a good job of getting that call by Tyrell Martinez. And UCAP will get the basketball. Looks to be a slippery spot over there. Players looking to wipe whatever could be condensation, could be sweat. We are in the sweat palace. I'm going to start calling this place the sweat palace, Bishop Conley Gymnasium over here. Because when you get into this building, all you do is sweat. Goodness gracious. Both coaches sweat right now. You can see the gleam off their bald heads in the corner. Or driving to the hole. No good. Tipped up and in. Or staying with it. Great hustle. He puts that back up and in. 75-72. Ricardo driving. Back out to Mendes. Open for three. Chad and Gia. No good. Hustling for it is Jernigan. And he can't get to it. It goes out of bounds. It's a one-possession game with 4:30 left to play. Birch. Going to McCree. Back to first. Swings it in the corner. Will Orr for three. Drains it! The trainer. Will Orr for three. Number three for three. 75-75. We're tied with 4 minutes to go. Get on the edge of the seat, everybody. We're going for a ride. Ricardo for two. No good. Rebounded by Orr. Orr trying to take this game into his hands. Up to McCree. Puts it up in it. No good. Blocked. Osias, no good. Tipped up. Rebounded by Baker. Corrals it. BCC needs to slow it down here. Need to slow it down, get into a play. Play within themselves right now. Play controlled from the top. Can't get it to go. Loose ball. And we got a new shot clock here. New 30-second shot clock. BCC needs to hold to get a good shot here. Can't play helter-skelter. It's all about execution. Down the stretch here. Getting into the lane, off the glass and in. Nice drive by Chad and Gia. I swear, every time you cap, ties it or takes the lead, Chad and Gia is back there to respond. Martinez gets the ball off the elbow, then slams it inside, using his muscle, puts it up and in. We're tied back, all sevens on the board. 2:50 to play. Mendes taking it in. Lost control of it. McCree, they got the numbers. Martinez is going to go up. And ooh, looks like he want to jam it. Luckily, he puts it up and in for their sake. 79-77. And wow. Martinez is drained after that play. He's been all over the place. He looks severely winded, but on that fast break, he gives the pointers the lead. With 2:32 to play. Boy, this has been a barn burner. This has turned into a barn burner here at the end. It's a big game for BCC. You get a chance to knock up a team like UCAP, who started the season off 2-0. 2-0 in Region 21. You're 2-2 overall, 2-2 in Region 21. This would be a good chance to get ahead at UCAP and the overall Region 21 standings early on in the season, but still. The players keep wiping their feet. Must be condensation or, like I said, a sweatshop here, so. A lot of slippery spots. Kind of reminds me of the old Boston Garden, that old parquet floor that used to always be slipping and sliding. Because that place was a sweatshop too back in the 80s, 70s, 60s, 50s, 40s. Old building. To 77. BCC inbound to their own backcourt. McCarthy. Mendes. Ten on the shot clock. BCC needs to conjure up something. He conjures something up quick. McCarthy gets it to the lane. Nice move. Gets it up off the glass to Jernigan. Jernigan puts it up off the glass. Ties it up. Nice play by McCarthy. Getting into the lane. At the last second, he finally cut in Desmond Jernigan. Under 2 minutes to go. Oh, lose it. Oh, he fell on that slippery spot. Holloway going to come away with it. Go into the hole. Loses it. He slips. Players have to wear cleats out there. Timeout. BCC was slipping and sliding on offense there. Couldn't gain control of themselves. And Rob Del Lue calls a much-needed timeout. That's a good timeout on his part. Keeping it up right here, and ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. This is going to be an exciting finish, 79-79. Both teams in foul trouble. Both teams will be going to the free throw line for the rest of this game. And what an exciting game it's been. BCC had a huge lead in the first half, a semi-huge lead, about 18 points, nearly 20 points in the first half. And then UCAP has just hung around. They fought, they clawed, they stayed with it, they persevered. And they were able to hang around and capitalize on BCC turnovers and really play great team basketball and hit their free throws. And to BCC's credit, they responded. Every time UCAP has made a run and has taken the lead, BCC has responded and hasn't gone anywhere. But it's going to be a tooth and nail finish here. Bishop Conley High School. BCC doesn't want to drop another home game. Got to win those home games. UConn with a long bus trip up here in the rain, got here late. So they can come away with this victory. It would definitely be a steal. The women's team already won today. They're in attendance. The women's UCAP basketball team, that is, the Pointers, with an outstanding performance. Tatiana LaFrance Boyce was the leading scorer for the UCAP Pointers today. 15 on the shot clock. Man-to-man defense. On the drive, Holloway going to pick up his dribble. McCarthy bouncing in the lane. Gets it inside to Baker. Laker gets blocked. Blocked by McCarthy. But it's going to stay here as it goes out of bounds. 3 seconds on the shot clock here. Will Orr will come in for Bobby Atkins. Holloway from underneath his own basket. It's got to be a quick shot. They get it to Jernigan. Tipped up, and it's good. Tipped up by Baker at the shot clock. Buzzer there. 81-79, 2-point lead. Tremendous play inside. Oh, it was a matchup. Martinez and Baker. No good. Baker wins that matchup. And a big rebound. And who goes to the free throw line? That's huge. Martinez and Baker, two similar type body types. Undersized forwards with solid builds, great athletic ability, muscling up against each other, and Baker just holding his ground there, hands up, used his body well, and was able to get the rebound too. He'll step up to the line for two free throws, both teams in the double bonus. Huge clutch free throw sunk there by Baker. This shot right here would make it a two possession game, 82-79. Nobody, that ball hit the rim, rebounded by Martinez, one possession game. Three pointer ties it, 82-79. 20 on the shot clock. Here's Will Orr. Will Orr driving to the hole, puts it up and in. Will Orr going fearless to the hole now. The game's coming to him. He's taking it to the hole now, fearlessly. 82-81. Don't need to force anything if you're BCC. You got the lead. Need a good shot. McCarthy crosses over. Back out to Holloway for three. Off the top of the backboard. Orr finds a cutting first. Over to Osias. What a block by Holloway. Saved by Jernigan. And not sure what that call is going to be as it hit the top of the divider. Hit the top of the rafters there where the divider is. And they're going to say it's UCAP basketball. .5 to go. The shot clock is off. UCAP can hold on to the. They can hold on to the. To the very end. They can hold for the last shot. Gersh being guarded closely by Holloway. You can't follow your BCC, and they do. You can't do that. You can't foul. You're up. You're only up by one. And it's going to be a two-shot foul with your team in the double bonus. And now Gersh has the biggest free throws of his young career so far. What a contrast this is from the women's basketball game. And Nick Gersh, freshman guard. He didn't start today, but he's definitely finishing. He's definitely done a good job with the basketball, passing, and finding guys. He misses the first free throw. Pressure free throws. Best he can do now is tie it. If you're BCC, you get the basketball. I think he called timeout on a make. Now this crowd getting into it. Both free throws missed. Martinez comes away with it. Loose ball. Rebounded by Baker. Gets it to McCarthy. They're going to call a foul now with 9 seconds to play. Monty Baker steps up to the line for two. 82-81. These are two big free throws here. And that's a big free throw right there. That's a big free throw right there. You ensure UCAP has to make a three to beat you. They'll try to ice him right now as we'll take a timeout here. Armani Baker still has one free throw remaining. So what a game. What a game you're watching here on FR Media. It's a pleasure to bring it to you here on FR Media Channel 95 on your Comcast dial. What a tremendous game it has been. As BCC tries to jump up to 3-2. Good to see the BCC crowd finally getting a little rise. A rise in their Levi's. .83-81, so it's a 2-point game. I think either way, if you're UCAP, I think you call a timeout, set yourself up, whether it's a make or a miss. Armani Baker with a huge free throw here. BCC, you got to defend the three-point line. I don't doubt that UCAP will go for the win here on the road with a three-pointer. Baker will miss it. Up off highest, Martinez. They won't call a timeout. Going around the back is McCree. Two, the shot. He traveled, and that's looks like it's going to be the ball game here. Martinez will come out. Great effort on his part today. Tremendous game by that guy. And they'll inbound the basketball, and that's going to be it. And I'm not sure if they're going to call it. If that's going to be it, that's going to be it. They inbound the basketball, that's going to be it. And BCC redeems themselves at home. And that's their second win in a row after winning Saturday against Gateway. Big win here today by BCC. They had a huge lead the first half. They experienced a little storm as UCAP hung around and kept themselves in it. And a back and forth game there, the final 4 or 5 minutes with a lot of lead changes. BCC persevered. And I tell you, that team showed great heart, great grit to survive this game here tonight, because they could have, UCAP got back in it, tied it, took the lead, and really gained a lot of momentum. But BCC, give them a lot of credit. Rob Del Lu's going to be happy with his team, even though they gave up that big lead. But BCC with an 83-81 victory over the University of Connecticut at Avery Point, the Pointers. So for David Cardoza here with Lucy Cabral, you've been watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media. The Bayhawks men's basketball team takes it here at home. See you later, everybody, from Fall River.